Welcome back to Ulti Finals. We got Ojama versus Zucht game 2. If Ojama wins this, we get a game 3. If Zucht wins, Zucht gets the trophy. Looking at the teams, I assume it's going to be SD, Ruse, the Bullet Punch, Knockoff, Scissor on Ojama's side. He doesn't have another Knockoff user. It's a good win condition, and Defog is most likely on the Zap. Then the Bulu is going to be some sort of bulky Spadefarian to help versus opposing Greninja. Scarfa is either the Greninja or the Victini. And the Garchomp is going to be Rocks. Not sure what the Z-move user is, though, because he has like so many potential Z users. On the other side, this guy brings a Mega Gardevoir to Ulti Finals, which is really funny to me. Most likely Spikes, Ferrothorn, Rocks, Chomp, Scarf, Defog, Landris. And yeah, most likely Z-move Tapu Lele. Garchomp looks like it has to be Tank Chomp on Zucht's team, just because he's really weak to SD Bulu and SD Kartana, those two mons. The Landris, like, could potentially be Scarf HP Fire to kind of help with the Kartana matchup, though if he's that set, then he's also really weak to Zygarde. So I think he probably has to be Scarf HP Ice Lando. So turn 1, Ojama is free to go for Spikes here, because Zucht should switch out into either Pex or Ferrothorn to scout for the Greninja being Scarf, or to scout for Water Shuriken from Battlebond Greninja. So Ojama reads that, makes the correct play, goes for Spikes. Okay, so now this Pex is a really big problem for Ojama. I assume we're going to see either Toxic or Toxic Spikes. The only one that is immune to Toxic on Ojama's side is the Scissor, and the Scissor cannot beat the Pex, so he can obviously not go to it. He's probably gonna go into the Garchomp. Zap usually cannot beat Pex unless it's like offensive with like Electrium or something like that, but I think it's just gonna be bulky Defog variant on this team. So yeah, I think Garchomp is gonna have to come out, and we're gonna see either Toxic or Toxic Spike. Throw that to Toxic. Now Zucht is gonna go into Landris to get off the Intimidate. And if Garchomp goes for SD, then he can either pivot or go for HP Ice. But Garchomp goes for Rocks, which I don't agree with. Now Zucht is really good. Defog the Hazards away. Another potential play that Ojama could have made is double into Greninja, anticipating the Landris to come out and prevent it from defogging and pressure it. But now Zucht is forced into the Garchomp here. This pool is a huge problem for Zucht's team. So I think the Garchomp is either going to have Fire Blast, Toxic, or Poison Jab. One of the three to kind of help with the Bulu matchup, because he's just so weak to it. If he's not one of those, then he has to be like Chopperberry Ferrothorn with Jarrowball or something like that, because he's just like Bulu kind of runs through his team, right? So if he's Chopperberry Chopperpharaoh with Jarrow, he can go to that, or otherwise he's gonna go to Garchomp, which is most likely helmet on this team. And then he's either gonna go for Toxic Fire Blast or Poison Jab. I assume Ojama is just gonna go for SD here, because this Bulu looks like it goes in on Zucht's team. So he goes for SD, and he's probably just gonna go for Horn Leech here. And now we see what Zucht has. He does have Poison Jam, does a million to the Bulu. Horn Leech is gonna get some health back, but he's also gonna take Rough Skin plus Rocky Helmet most likely. And now Ojama's gonna switch out here. He doesn't have a safe switch into the Garchomp. Zucht could go for Roxy, anticipating the switch. The thing is, like, he can't really go Scissor, because what if this Garchomp has Fire Blast? I guess it's unlikely to have Fire Blast, so if Ojama is confident it doesn't have that, he can go Scissor. I would probably go into Greninja here from Ojama, because it can eat a Poison Jab, it covers the Rocks play, it also covers the potential Fire Blast play, but he goes into Zap instead, which means he might have HP Ice Zap, or he just wants to defog the Rocks away. So if Zucht has Toxic on the Chomp, he can go for it here, otherwise he's probably going to switch out into what would be one of the two fairies, either the Gardevoir or the Lele. Going Gardevoir or Lele also scouts for HP Ice, but instead he goes for Toxic, predicting the Defog. Yeah, if he had Toxic, then it was a completely fine play. I just wasn't sure if he had it. But yeah, if Ojama has HP Ice, which he might have because he brought Zapdos in on Chomp, then he's probably going to go for it here, so Zucht should scout for that by switching into one of the two fairies. Though if Zap would be HP Ice, it probably wouldn't have Heat Wave, which is kind of odd to me. Since he already has Bulu and Scizor, I thought Ojama would have a fine Zygarde matchup. But he might, I think he has HP Ice in this, because he brought it in on the Chomp. So he goes into, Gardevoir. I was going to say he should go into one of the two fairies. I think I already said it, right? The scout for HP Ice, exactly, makes the correct play, and he does have HP Ice. So now Zucht is free to go for Hyper Voice. Ojama is probably just going to throw the Victini in. There's no point going Scizor here and risking a potential HP Fire or Will-O-Wisp or something along those lines. So Victini is always the play. Hyper Voice comes out, does a decent chunk. Considering that Game Freak nerfed the 8 abilities, like Aerial 8, Pixelate, they nerfed them a bit. So considering that, there was still a decent amount of damage, because it's a resist and Victini has good natural bulk. But I think we're just going to see the Garchomp come out here from Zucht. This Victini is most likely a choice guard variant, unless it has like Icy Wind, it can't really do much to the Chomp as he V-creates. Now he's gonna take Rough Skin plus Rocky Helmet. The thing is, he might still outspeed the Garchomp, but that depends on the Garchomp. If the Garchomp is really fast, Garchomp is faster. Ojama probably knows if he's faster or not, because he already Horn-leeched the Garchomp with the Bulu, so from that damage he can tell how much bulk the Chomp has. So if he knows that he's slower, then he's gonna have to switch out. If he switches into Zap, knowing that he's most likely slower, okay. So this might actually be max speed Rocky Helmet Chomp, because Victini is base 100, so with a Scarf, Chomp needs like a lot of speed to still outspeed it, right? So he's just gonna defog here. Zucht takes that as an opportunity to get the Lille in, and this Lille is most likely Z-move. He's potentially gonna go for Shattered Psych here if he has that, or he's just gonna go for Psychic. I guess it could also be All Out Pummeling, because that would help Gardevoir to get rid of Heatran. But he just goes for Psychic as Zapdos dies to Poison. Don't think that's Specs damage, unless it was like a low roll Specs. I think it might be just non-Specs and he got a high roll. Or maybe it wasn't a high roll, and maybe he was just modest Z-move Lille. That could also be it. Zap was faster, which means it was either super fast Zap or the Lille was modest. One of the two things. So now Ojama's in a tough spot. Victini comes out, and yeah, since now Ojama lost his defogger, Zucht can sack something, which is probably the Gardevoir, and then afterwards he can go Garchomp if he outspeeds it. I mean, Zucht obviously knows his Garchomp spread, and he knows if he outspeeds Scar Victini after the drop, so he can sack something here. He cannot sack the Lille, because he wants to keep the Lille around, basically, because if Scizor somehow, like, SD knockoff crits through the Toxapex and never gets burned, then he needs the Lille to stop Scizor from bullet punching it and checking it with HP fire, right? That's why he needs to keep Lille around, so he cannot sack it. But he can sack something else. I don't think he wants to sack the Garchomp, because after sacking something, he can then go Garchomp afterwards, get the rocks up, and Ojama has no way to get rid of the hazards. And then Ojama's team will get chipped, and he's just in a tough spot, it seems, because his Bulu is already super low. His Garchomp is toxic and on a timer, so it just looks like Ojama is getting weaker and weaker to packs. So he does sack off the Gardevoir. Now he goes Garchomp, confirming that he's faster than Victini. Gets up rocks. Ojama knows he's gonna go for rocks, and he kills it. Rough Skin plus Rocky Helmet is gonna bring the Victini low. Now he can bring out the Lille or the Landris here. Goes Lille. He's probably gonna go for Moonblast at this point, because he doesn't want to Psychic into the Greninja. But I think Ojama's just gonna sack the Victini, because he doesn't have a switch into the Lille, at least not a safe switch in. And yeah, Victini does to rocks. He has no way to get rid of the hazards. So now he's either gonna go Greninja or Scizor. Like, the thing is, he doesn't know yet if the Lille is Scarf. It could technically still be Scarfed, I think. No, the Zap does outspeed the Lily, right? If Zap outspeed the Lily, then it can't be Scarf, and he knows that. But yeah, like, if Greninja kills it from this range, then Greninja is a potential play, is what I'm trying to say. Let me calc on the side. Greninja. Otherwise, I think Garchomp can definitely kill it with Earthquake, so you can go to that to threaten it out. Scizor could also come out, because there's no terrain up at the moment. Yeah, Scizor can definitely come out and threaten it with a Bullet Punch, because terrain is down at the moment. But yeah, Greninja does 69 minimum with Dark. Oh, that's an Ash form, my bad. Let me recalc. Greninja does... Yeah, okay, Greninja does not kill with Dark Pulse, so he's not gonna go Greninja. Greninja only kills it with Hydro Pump. There's no point going Greninja to Hydro Pump, because that would just give Zucht a free packs or free Pharaoh. If you go Greninja, I think you might have to make an aggressive play and Spike. But he goes Scizor since the terrain is down, and he just threatens it with a Bullet Punch. I also want to know how much Garchomp would have done though to it with Earthquake. 74 to 87 if it's offensive, but it might be Tank Chomp, I guess. Which means the Z-move would then be on Bulu. Like, Z-move is either on the Chomp or on the Bulu. But yeah, now Ferrothorn can actually go for Spikes. Yeah, Zucht was always going to switch there into either Pharaoh or Pex. And I think he's just going to get up a Spike here. Ojama knocks off the leftovers. And Spikes are amazing for Zucht in this game, as he does get up a layer. Ojama has no way to get rid of the hazards, and now he has Spikes and Rocks on his side, so he's probably gonna Roost here. Zucht can either switch out into his Toxapex, playing it safe, or he can also go Lille, as he does go Lille, which is a bit risky, but it covers the SD, it covers the Roost. And if he Z-move, he could also live a knockoff. So yeah, I guess in that sense, it wasn't even that risky. Now he's probably just gonna HP Fire, because even if Ojama switches into Greninja or Garchomp, they still take Rocks plus Spikes, so this is completely fine for Zucht. And Scizor is kind of a threat if it, like, if Pex never burns it, Scizor can potentially beat it, like I said earlier. So he doesn't want to play around with this, so I think he's just going to throw the HP fire. I still would like, I don't remember if the, yeah, I think the Zapdos already outsped the Lily earlier, so I'm pretty, it's pretty obvious that the Lily isn't Scarf, and the Landris, it's pretty obvious that the Landris is the Scarf, yeah, I just wasn't sure. So we're gonna see either the Garchomp or the Greninja come out here, and Zucht is just gonna throw the HP fire. Like I said, he doesn't mind too much if Chomp or Gren come out. Then if Gren comes out, Zucht would have to probably just go into the Pex. And if Chomp comes out, he would probably just go into the Landorus. Those are the options. Well, Jama is just thinking long and hard about this play. There's also a Little Cup going on, a Little Cup game going on. Hopefully my man Seal will guest narrate that for you guys. But yeah, Jama is just taking his time here. I just think Zucht is in a really good position to win with his Toxapex, and like I said, keeping Lily around obviously helps to check the Scizor. Because like the monster that can beat Pex, Chomp is toxic and has to take hazards if it comes out. Greninja relies on flinching Pex to beat it. He still also has Scarf Landris, which helps with the Greninja as well if Pex gets flinched. Though if Pex is in range of Dark Pulse, and like if Pex gets flinched and the next Dark Pulse would kill it, then I think Zucht would sack something else instead. I don't think he would sack the Pex if it comes to that. And yeah, Scizor can only beat Pex if it like SDs up and never gets burned, and even then I'm not sure how much knockoff does. Might also depend on the Pex spread, especially if Pex has some Fist Death, it should be able to beat Scizor quite easily. Like, it might have some Fist Death since he also has a Ferrothorn to check Greninja. But it's definitely more a Spit Death variant, the Pex, because that also helps with the Megina matchup. Like, Pex and Ferro, when you have both on a team, like, sometimes one of them is more Fist Death, but it still makes sense for both to be Spit Death. Because they, like, check kind of the same mons, like Greninja, but they also check different mons. Like, Megina, if it's Z-Focus Blast, it can beat Ferro, so it's good to have Pex to scout for that. If it's Z-Electric, it's good to have Ferro to scout for that. So, like, between the bows, if you predict correct, you can usually beat most Megina sets. Or at least check them, right? But yeah, Ojama is not gonna stay in here, that's pretty obvious. Either the Greninja or the Chomps are gonna come out. Maybe he's just running some Kalks for the late game. But yeah, goes on the Garchomp on the HP Fire. And now Zucht is most likely just going to go into Landris. Ojama could go for the rocks here. He kind of has to go for the rocks. He couldn't really do much else there. I guess, no, SDing, there was no point in SDing because Lander would just outspeed him and kill him. Now Zucht's just going to click Earthquake here. Ojama really doesn't have a great play. He might just stay in with the Garchomp. If he's Bulky Chomp, he can maybe live a hit and get some damage off with Fire Blast, Dragon Tail, or potentially get off a Toxic. If he's not Bulky Chomp, he will just go down here. If he's a Z-move Chomp. I don't remember, but I think this Chomp never attacked in this game. So we don't know this Chomp's spread yet. It does live an Earthquake. Okay, so that means it's probably Tank Chomp. And the Toxic kind of confirms that. Because Offensive Chomp doesn't really run Toxic. I guess that made sense. If he also has Fire Blast on the Chomp, that makes a lot of sense to me. Since the Zapdos was HP Ice. Fast Zap without Heat Wave, I think. So he could have potentially kind of been weak to Kartana, if, especially if the Scizor is more of an offensive variant. Now he still has checks for Kartana, but he might also have Fire Blast on that Chomp. I'm not 100% sure though. So now, if he goes Greninja, Zucht would switch out to Scout for Water Shuriken. If he goes Bulu, I'm not sure if Bulu can live an Earthquake. Bulu's at like 5% after Hazard, so I doubt it could live a hit. But yeah, let me run some Kalks here, Bulu. Yeah, good Bulu versus Landris. Earthquake in grassy terrain. Assuming the Landris is, let's say the Land only has a bit of attack investment. Oh, I didn't put max HP, so he has Protect, which means he can actually potentially live this next Earthquake. If Landris is max attack, Earthquake does 21 to 25. Wait, no, that's not in. Earthquake does 11 to 13. My bad, I mixed up HP and Earthquake. Earthquake does 11 to 13 if he's max attack, but if he's not max attack, then it only does like 10-12% and Ujamaa has a chance to live it. If it's like 120 attack, if it's not attack invested, then it only does 9.6-11.3. So depending on the Lando spread, Ujamaa might be able to live a hit here. So Zucht probably doesn't want to risk that. He doesn't want to risk losing his Landorus. Since the Garchomp was tank jump, this Bulu is probably Z, because we didn't see leftovers in the Bulu after it protected. So it's probably either Fight Z or Grassium. So Zucht is going to switch out here and not risk the roll with Earthquake. Unless he's max attack and he's confident that it's killed. But he probably doesn't want to risk it, and he's probably just going to switch out into the Ferrothorn. And I guess if Ujamaa wants to predict that, he can go for SD. Because if he only just into the Ferrothorn, he's kind of... screwed. I mean, he's already in a tough spot anyway, but he has to make some plays at this point. So he does get the play ready, SDs. Now he can protect again to get some health. Though, I don't know if he wants to protect, because that could potentially give him a spike. Yeah, he had Z moves, which is all pummeling, and that's amazing for Ujamaa, because that doesn't take Iron Barbs, but he's still in a tough spot. Like, he kind of brought it back a little bit, but I don't think that's enough. So he's going to protect here, but if Zucht has the Z, he can just fire it off, and that goes through the protect. That's if he's Shattered Psych. If he's Fight Z, he's obviously just gonna go for a raw Moonblast. But if he has Shattered Psych, he can go for that. Ujamaa has to protect, because otherwise he cannot live a hit. And even if he protected, I don't know if he could have lived a hit, but he just Z moves and it kills hard through the protect. I would like to run a Kalk here. But yeah, now Zucht is obviously gonna go Toxapex here. And this game is pretty much wrapped up at this point. Zucht has to choke at this point to lose. He always goes Pex here. We're most likely gonna see a Dark Pulse from the Greninja. Now Zucht is gonna go for Recover, even if Ujamaa gets the... Well, if Ujamaa gets the flinch, it gets really annoying for Zucht. If Ujamaa gets the flinch, I guess then Zucht would be forced to maybe sack the Lele and then come in with the Scarf Landris to force out the Greninja that is locked into Dark Pulse. So if he got the flinch, that could have been really bad for Zucht. So now Zucht is just gonna Scald, because he cannot go hard Lele. If he goes hard Lele here, then the terrain ends and then he can get bullet punched the next turn. So he's just gonna Scald, trying to get the burn as Scissor goes for SD, and he gets burned. That's pretty much game over. If he didn't get burned there, I think Ujamaa still might have had a slight chance. It was tough anyway, because the Pex would have gotten multiple chances to burn him, because he would have been forced to roost. There's the haze. Also, yeah, I guess if the Pex was not haze, this Scissor could have also been annoying for Zucht. But yeah, getting the burn early and being haze, both combined, pretty much means game over. If Zucht wants, he could even go hard Lele on the Roost, but he just goes for Recover with the Pex. And I guess he's just going to play it safe here, click Scald into haze, which is completely fine. This Pex can also solo Ujamaa at this point, unless the Greninja flinches it down. You guys can see the next knockoff does absolutely nothing. Because obviously knockoff, I think it's only base 65. After you knock off the item, it gets weakened. And now Scizor's forced to roost. I don't know if Zucht is going to stay in here, because if he stays in, this is going to take forever. I thought he might have gone Lele there, but he doesn't. He just hazes, which is completely fine for Zucht. He doesn't have to risk anything. He pretty much wins this game, and that means he will win OLT. I'm honestly really surprised by that. I had Ujamaa as the clear favorite going into this set, but yeah. Ujamaa, I feel like he has been playing amazing overall, over the, like in Smoke on Snake Draft and in OLT. For the most part, besides one or two off games, he played really fire. So that's why I had him as the favorite. Zucht played well played well, and he brought like creative teams, which is what I liked. And he's German, so I obviously don't mind him winning. Should I say some German outro if this guy wins? I don't know. But yeah, now he goes Lele anticipating the Roost, or even if he knocks off, he can lift that. As he does, he's able to eat that up. And now he can just go for HP Fire. And it's pretty much game over. Greninja is super low at this point. And can Greninja even live a HP Fire? I really don't remember how healthy the Greninja is. It's at 76. Okay, so he's gonna HP Fire into the Gren, no reason to risk anything, and now he just goes back into Pex. Lele is still outside of range from rocks, and even if it wasn't, he doesn't need the Lele to win at this point. He can actually even sack the Lele, yeah, exactly, he can do that. Because he can now, he knows that it's Pex from the damage that the Greninja did to his Pex. Now he can just click Earthquake with the Landorus, assuming he's Scarf, and he just wins. Which is obvious that he's Scarf, just from how the game has been played. So he can just click Scarf Earthquake here. Ghost Scissor, which is going to die after the hazards. If it somehow doesn't die to Earthquake, it has to burn. But it was obvious that it would die at 19%. And now if Greninja comes back in, if it locks into Water Shuriken, then the Pex wins. If it locks into Dark Pulse, he dies to Scarf Earthquake. So, grats to Zuchtrest. Zuchtrest is how you pronounce it in German, but some people, I don't think, like when I say it like that. Actually, I think people haven't said anything about it, yeah. But yeah, Zuchtrest or whatever is how you would say it if you're from America, right? And he actually beats Lojama too. I did not expect this at all, like I already said. I thank you guys for watching. If you want to see both players run two finals, I recorded almost all the games live. I just haven't uploaded them yet because my computer is awful and has long render times. So yeah, I will still be uploading that. Hit that like button if you enjoyed. And even if you didn't enjoy, hit that like button because I'm putting in the effort. I mean, you're already 20 minutes into the video, so you might as well leave a like if you're still watching. Yeah, I appreciate the support. I think, yeah, you guys have been, like, lately, there have been a little bit more comments on the videos, which is cool for me. But yeah, herzlichen Glückwunsch, Zuchtrest. I just have to say it in German real quick. It's pretty much congratulations to win OLT. And yeah, I mean, I would have been fine with both players winning. Ojama definitely would have deserved it as well. But the other guy brings creative teams. Also had some cool games. So happy for him. And that's pretty much it. Peace out, friends. Stay tuned for more content the next days. Goodbye.